Experts are this morning sounding the alarm over Melbourne's hotel quarantine system, fearing the program is not fit to contain mutant strains of COVID-19.
Disturbing. We're joined now by GP and former president of the Australian Medical Association, Dr. Tony Bartone in Melbourne. Good morning to you, Doc. Tony, these breaches are of huge concern, aren't they?
Good morning, Carl. Look, any breach is obviously a concern, but we know that the quarantine system was never going to be 100% foolproof. But clearly, three events over the last week or so, they have drawn attention to what is currently in play. We know that the questions now raised around whether there is a role for airborne transmission. Mm. We know that the virus is much more transmissible, but the counterbalance to that is that each time that it's gotten out, there have been no cases in the community late last week, and of course we've got to wait and see on this one. But that does point to the fact that there is still a lot more that we need to learn about this current strain and how it's progressing. Certainly, it raises the spotlight on the ventilation systems in the hotel. Are they all fit for purpose? And of course, the occupational physicians doing their testing at the moment is a very timely next step.
Okay, let's talk about the AstraZeneca vaccine. South Africa has announced it's stopping its rollout. Can we have confidence in the vaccine if there's a whole country that's saying, no, it's not worth doing?
Look, of course, every country to their own, but what we do know is that the AstraZeneca vaccine is extremely, extremely effective, very high rate of effectiveness in preventing serious disease or hospitalisation, especially in that vulnerable elderly group. So that's the key target, that's the key measure that we need to base anything on. Of course, what we have seen also in various early data, which is yet to be completely peer-reviewed and worked through, is that there might be a reduction in some of that effectiveness on some of the other strains, in particular the South African strain. But we need to understand that clearly as the virus evolves, as the rollout rolls out, so to speak, we're going to get more and more data. We've got millions and millions of people around the world being immunised, and that all feeds back into further data. This is going to be one of the most extensively evidence-based and data-driven processes, you might say. And, of course, we're going to tweak that vaccine over time with any other additional information that comes through. But it's about understanding that this is going to be particularly now, it looks like, a longer game. We might need to look at a multi-year strategy, but in the first instance, it's about protecting our frontline healthcare staff and our most vulnerable groups and preventing them from getting serious illness or indeed having to be hospitalised and indeed lose their battle with COVID-19.
Look, I think that's a really great point because all of that information, and it is flooding out of the UK now, we get to sit back here. It is an advantage, isn't it, in the delay that we're having in terms of getting the vaccine. The UK is effectively saying this is going to become a yearly vaccine in order to keep up with the different variants. That's what we're looking at realistically.
And essentially, yes. So the first line is get the jab and get as much protection out there into the community from any serious illness. But of course, as we get more information, we'll look at the next step and the next step. We've got 20 million doses of Pfizer on order during this current rollout, proposed rollout period. Of course, the AstraZeneca is being prepared here in Melbourne. That gives us an enormous advantage when it comes to supply and logistics. That's and then the distribution through such a wide land like Australia. So we need to look at combining all that smarts and all the evidence and all the data that comes in. But of course, the most important thing is to get out there and get vaccinated when your turn comes up.
Yep.
Doctor, thank you.
Thanks, Tony.